It's modern, sleek, high-tech. It's a toilet seat, and it might just be the next generation in home care.
Most of the data that is collected may be more applicable to someone's health is what happens to them at home. Only 10% of the data that relates to a person's health is captured in the electronic medical record, and 90% of what matters to someone's health is not observed because the patient is home.
The heart seat is a new technology now being tested in a clinical trial at the UMass Chan Medical School in Worcester called Collating Outcomes with Mobile Monitoring, or Commode. The device is capable of a host of passive data collection. In the same way a smartwatch monitors data on your wrist, the smart toilet monitors data through your backside.
So we just sit our buns right on these little sensors and it does all the work?
It does all of the work. It lets us know more than just heart health. It lets us know how someone's flight or fight response or what their stress versus rest or minute response is.
Lead researcher Dr. Apurv Soni says the battery lasts a full year. No pesky charging issues. Temperature, heart rate, oxygen levels, a complete data dump, all recorded by these embedded sensors.
And these sensors are called ballistocardiogram.
Okay.
And it measures tiny pressure differences as blood traverses through your buttocks and thigh region. And based off of that, with use of advanced analytics and artificial intelligence models, we can actually calculate blood pressure.
Perhaps a futuristic application, but this smart toilet may someday not only help patients monitor their health at home, help their doctors obtain more accurate readings, but also maybe even prevent a trip to the ER.
Someone could sit down on this toilet and you could, in the future, recognize that they might be in distress or having an issue, send a medic right to their home.
Right.
Just from their morning bathroom routine.
Right. So that if it's a patient who has a little bit more volume in their body because they have congestive heart failure and they had a little bit more salt, then we can get a paramedic to their home, provide some medications like LASIK, which allows them to get some of that fluid out, and then that can prevent a hospitalization. Data would come in. There would be a command center that's looking at the data. If we think that the suspicion is high enough for something catastrophic to happen, we can send paramedic right away. But a step below that, we can call the patient at home and ask them how they're doing. So the idea is to be more proactive as opposed to reactive.
Wow, there's technology for everything, which is amazing. The heart seat has been installed in select patients' homes who are part of the trial.
Yeah, and vitals are as unique as a fingerprint, so if there's multiple people in the house, you can just collect the data from the patient you're looking for, which is incredible. All right, that is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. I'm Anthony Everett.
And I'm Shana Seymour. Have a wonderful evening. We'll see you back here tomorrow night. Good night, everyone.